Hello everyone, this is Oscar Echo 5, Juliet, Foxtrot Echo, Joe here with another video for the Vector Antenna Analyzer from the Funkamateur version 5, Fox Alpha Victor Alpha 5, designed by Delta Golf 5 Mike Hilo, and I will show you how to update to the latest firmware version, which is 1.08, and then we will do a basic setup, and yeah. Hope I can show you how this works. And first of all, we will connect to the PC via the mini USB jack here, and you heard the sound system came up and it's turned into USB mode. And first of all, we'll find out which COM port we are using currently. So we'll have here, we are having here our device manager, in German Geräte manager. And you see here the new device came up here, COM 4. This is what we will need later. And to allow us to do the firmware update, you see I've prepared here the old version 1.07 and the new version 1.08, and I've unzipped the 1.08 just using 7-zip here, or the integrated unzipper. And you will find here in the extracted folder, so definitely you need to extract it, you can't run it from the zip. You will find here this batch file, and this is actually what's performing the update. You will find here the Readme files in English and in German on how to do the update. I will just quickly bring them up here so that we can have a look together. So main instructions are, we unzip it, we have Java 7 or newer installed, that's confirmed. We found out where our virtual COM port is, so this is also done in the device manager. And we will press the left button on the to get into the menu and head for setup firmware. And then we will launch our batch file to do the update. Let's switch over back here. I'm holding the menu button, moving further down on this particular device setup menu, and I'm hitting firmware, and you see it flashing, and now we can launch the program here, the batch file. This is what we're gonna do, and you see here, bringing it up here on the center, it says here we need to enter the COM port, and I'm really typing in COM4, this is what we found. Hitting enter, and you see the progress bar coming up, and the screen stopped to flash, and the update that is going on. So we'll take a few, this will take a few seconds more. Looks okay, and we saw the boot screen coming up with the version 1.08, so that's the first part successfully done. I'm hitting here button on the keyboard, and the job here on the PC basically is done. And to not have any disturbance here, I will disconnect here, and bring up again the instructions, and you see here most important part will be to do a full reset, so go to setup and reset, because the information saved in the EEPROM has changed, and this is what I will do. So I will power up the device, you see battery is up and software version 1.08, and we're just coming up here with the latest settings. So I'm holding the menu button, and you will see that we have a new option here in this firmware version. We just can't only go up and down, but we have a rotating menu, so I just can go up and kind of roll over to the
lower end of the menu, which is really helpful. And just going through all of that, and just to, so reset, yes, I'm confirming the reset. So back to default settings, you see here 2 megahertz is the default. See, this shows you that the reset was successful. I will just quickly hit the menu for the backlight mode, so that it's better visible, keeping it on. So, and now we will have to go through all the settings, and the most important part will be to do the calibration again. So I want to do a master calibration. You see it here, calibration port model master. And to do so, I will need the details from my calibration kit. So I'm having here my calibration kit, and it comes with a little brochure, with a little piece of paper. This is having all the relevant information, and I will just put it next to the device so that we can have a look together. So what we will first need is the short delay. So this is the value down here, male short delay, -113. Then the open delay, so we are here in this section, male open delay. I'll set this as the next. Go down to the -41. Of course, these parameters will be a bit different for your kit. I'm using here the professional kit as it is marketed on the sales page, on the shop page. So now for the third parameter, load delay. This is referring now to the simple model, and this is the load delay here we are looking at. So I'm again setting the values here, going down to -56.24. Logging that in, we have a load of, so we are not exactly at 50 ohm. Now we can just go here and go down to 0 the load capacity in that case is 0 femtofarad. And the inductance of 3.29. This is also what we are logging in here. Enter. So you see we have all the parameters. The port delay is 0 because we are measuring right at the BNC check, not in the further down the cable. Hitting return. And we are doing now the actual master calibration here in the calibration model master. Hitting, oh no, we have this done already. We can go for the calibration now here, solve all frequencies and hit OK. And we first start with the short. So this is the short from the professional kit you see here. This is the short, get it on. So we are approaching now the 600 megahertz, which is the upper range, and this was the closed element. clicking this off. And now it asks for the open element. So we are having the open element here. Putting that on the PNZ connector, and another 600 megahertz counting upward. So, and this was the second part of the sole calibration, taking away the open connector, and now I'm having here the 50 ohm, or as we saw before in the parameters, close to 50 ohm, and this is just the serial number from my particular kit, but this is the 50 ohm going on, and another 600 megahertz counting upwards and measuring and setting a new baseline. So we are reaching the 600 megahertz. This is the first run, which was slower, and now a fast verification run. I guess the 50 ohm resistor should give us a constant low SWR, VSWR of 1.0 if everything went smoothly. Let's see if this is okay. So I'm hitting return, going for the 5 band SWR mode, and here we are. So all the bars are down to 1. This is how it should be with the calibration piece. Checking here. So turn up the frequency to let's say 2 meter band. I think right on the call frequency, and we see SWR of 1 and impedance of 50 ohm and everything at standard. You see here we are on the master calibration and 50 ohm. So everything's good, I would say. So thanks a lot for watching, and if I have something new to share with the vector analyzer, I will let you know. 73, this is Oscar Echo 5, Juliet Foxtrot Echo, goodbye.